One of the most frequent questions that I've received from viewers and listeners to Ring of Fire every time I do a Q&A is, what happens to Donald Trump if he goes to jail and he still has Secret Service protection? And that is a question that the media has also asked and unfortunately been unable to answer, because the real answer is that nobody knows. Thanks to a bill signed by former President Obama back when he was still president, former presidents get Secret Service protection for life. Now, a lot of people already thought that happened, but no. Actually, prior to that bill that Obama signed, you only got it for 10 years, then you're on your own. But Obama, of course, said, you know what? Let's do it for the rest of our lives. And at that point, okay, not really that big of a deal. But now it's a big deal when we have a former president who is looking at the very real prospect of going to prison, and it's not really fair to force Secret Service agents to sit in a prison cell with him 24 hours a day. Luckily, a Democratic lawmaker this past week introduced a bill that would address that. Democratic lawmaker Bennie Thompson introduced legislation called the Disgraced Former Protectees Act that would strip anybody receiving Secret Service protection of their protection if they are convicted of a felony. Now, he made it clear this is about Donald Trump. And Bennie Thompson also understands Democrats don't control the House of Representatives, so this legislation is absolutely not going to pass. But I'll get more to that in a minute, and it's still a very smart idea. But here's what he said. Unfortunately, current law doesn't anticipate how Secret Service protection would impact the felony prison sentences of a protectee, even a former president. It is regrettable that it has come to this, but this previously unthought-of scenario could become our reality. This measure would apply to former President Trump if he is convicted of a felony, and if passed, the measure would remove some of the potential complications and logistical concerns that would come with incarcerating the 77-year-old former president should he be sentenced to serve time behind bars. And yes, this has been a concern of the prosecutors. It's been a concern of judges. They're like, what do I do? Because he's got these people that have to be around him every minute of every day. Do I send them to jail too? Like, how does that work? How do jails handle that? These people coming in and out every single day. Bennie Thompson smartly said, okay, you got a concern with this? This is a big problem. I'll handle it. I'll handle it with this piece of legislation right here. Let's get this done right now, he says. Again, not going to pass. So why bother, right? Well, the why bother is because we've got an election coming up in November. Republicans aren't looking too good in that election. Democrats have the real chance to retain the Senate, maybe pick up a seat or two, who knows? And they're more than likely going to take back the House of Representatives. At that point, all Benny Johnson has to do is change the date on his legislation, reintroduce it, bring it to the floor, and pass it. So what he's done right now is he's put it out there in the ether. And he's done the groundwork, right? He's got it framed up, written up, ready to go. It's not going to pass right now, but next January could be a totally different story. So this was a good idea. Put the thought out there right now to the judges who will be delivering sentences if he is convicted. Let them know, hey, I got you covered, so you don't have to worry about it. That's a pretty smart idea. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.